Hi everyone, and welcome back to Creative PowerPoint. Today, we'll build this magnifying glass effect in PowerPoint. You can use this technique whenever you want to zoom on an object in a slide, but also want your audience to continue seeing the big picture. In one PowerPoint slide, we have this image. It's an image well suited for this effect. As you can see, there are a lot of details in this scene. We'll start by duplicating the image with Command-D on a Mac or Control-D on Windows. Then, with a new image selected, go to the Picture Format tab and press the Crop button. Drag the black crop handles to form a square around the first object you want to highlight. It's not a problem if the square is not perfect at this stage. Press the Escape key once you're done. Make sure that the size of this area is big enough so that everything you'll need to highlight later also fits in the size of that square. A simple way to check is to move your cropped image on the parts of the image you'll want to highlight and make sure they are covered. Let me undo a couple of times to go back to my initial state. Before we crop to a circle, we need to make sure the height is exactly the same as the width. Otherwise, we are going to end up with an oval. To do so, go to the Picture Format tab, click on the drop-down button next to the Crop button, select Aspect Ratio, and then 1:1. PowerPoint will adjust your crop to make it perfectly square and keep the cropping mode active. Press the Escape key to go out of cropping mode. Then head to the Crop drop-down again, and this time, select Crop to Shape and select the oval shape. Now, PowerPoint will adjust the crop to make a perfect circle. You can now move the cropped image to position it over its location on the original image. Let's make this cropped image bigger to give that magnifying effect. Drag the handles to resize the image, and hold the Control key to resize around the image center. Go to the Format Image pane and set an outline. In our case, a 6 points wide dark line. To give a more believable magnifying glass effect, in the Effects tab, go to the 3D Format section. Set the circle top bevel. Set the width to half of the circle size. We see in the Picture Format pane that our image width and height is 4.51 cm. We will divide this value by 2. This gives us 2.255 cm. Let's enter this value, followed by the unit in the width box. As you can see, PowerPoint converts this value automatically into points. Set the height as per your taste. I've set it to 8 points. You can choose your material. I've kept the default one. You can also choose your lighting. I've also kept the default one. Set the lighting angle according to the lighting of the scene. We have created our first slide. Let's create a second one with another detail highlighted. Duplicate the slide. Select the magnifying glass on the new slide. Go to the Picture Format menu and press Crop. Drag the picture so that the new area you want to highlight fits within the black crop handles. Once you are done, press the Escape key. Reposition the cropped image so that it overlays on the corresponding section of the bottom image. Let's repeat this step multiple times to highlight multiple sections of the slide. Once this is done, select all slides, go to the Transition tab, and make sure the Morph Transition is selected. Let's go to Slideshow mode and see the final result.
voilà. Thanks for watching, don't forget to like, comment and subscribe, and I see you next week. Bye bye.